You say you feel less puzzled about the issue or mystery of jobs now. How is that?
Well, during an entire year, our team was conducting research on jobs and development, but it was not just our team. We went out to 24 countries for consultations. We had a panel of experts, policymakers, advisors from developing countries, from academia, and gradually a clear picture emerged. And the picture that emerged is that much of what we care about in development actually happens through jobs. Jobs are not, should not be an afterthought of growth. Really, development is what happens when the right jobs appear.
So is this also a new insight in economics?
Well, probably this is not a revolution in economics. It will be completely pretentious to say that. I think what we do is we take jobs out of a labor market analysis. Remember that in developing countries, most people are farmers or self-employed. We take it out of the labor market and we put it in development policy. So we go from labor economics to development economics. And when we do that, we realize that things like gender analysis, poverty analysis, urban economics, all of them happen to a large extent through jobs. So there's no analytical revolution, it's just looking at the problem from a different angle.
You've gone through a lot of research and data on, for instance, household surveys. What's the data challenge been for you?
In some areas, research has led us to have good data. 20 years ago, priority was given to poverty, and by now in every country we have good household surveys that cover the entire population. It is not like that for things related to jobs. When you look at the kind of surveys we use, they tend to be labor force surveys to measure unemployment in cities. In countries that are still rural, where few people are wage employees, this is not the relevant instrument. We have planned level surveys, but that look at the formal sector. In developing countries, you have, even in relatively rich developing countries like Chile, you have a myriad micro enterprises. So not having a look at what happens at the low end gives you a completely distorted picture. If you ask someone who creates more jobs, is it the large, the small, the micro enterprises, the answer, I will not trust it because the data is missing. So one of the things we did is to take every database that was really nationally representative that we could have access to the microdata and process it. And there is an enormous statistical annex to the report that is available online, can be downloaded from anywhere in the world, but this is an agenda that needs to continue.
If you try to get those easy points, I mean, name three key points that you know people should take home from the World Development Report 2013.
Well, I would say a first very important one is jobs drive development. So things like gender equality, functional cities, getting out of conflict depends on jobs. It's not just something that you get as an input for production. So jobs are more than just an input for production. That will be one. Second is, it's not just the number of jobs. We have focused too much of our analysis on unemployment problems. In developing countries, poor people work. It's not that they are out of a job, it's that the jobs are not sufficient to make them and help them make ends meet. So it's not just the number of jobs, it's what kind of jobs. And perhaps a third one is that the nature of the jobs challenge is very different depending on the country. The jobs that will give you the development transformation in an agrarian economy are not the same as in an aging society or in a resource-rich country. We came up with a typology of jobs challenges, age jobs challenges. Some countries individually can combine two or three of them, but having clarity of where are those jobs, when is that getting jobs for young people will contribute to peace, when is that getting jobs for women will contribute to improvements in health and education for children, when is that functional cities is what is missing. That's, I think, one third message we would like to leave from this report.
Okay, thank you very much.